Horns up and welcome to a brand new episode of Headbanger's Kitchen. It is accidentally barbecue week on HK because, well, I made the keto barbecue sauce and then I showed you how to make my famous bacon bomb with that barbecue sauce and I had barbecue sauce left over. So I said, what am I going to do with it? So I said, let me show you guys a few more recipes with that delicious keto barbecue sauce. So today we're going to be cooking up some barbecue chicken and we're going to be using some legs and some thighs and we're going to wrap it in some lovely prosciutto or Parma ham, I can't remember which one it is, but yeah, it's going to be delicious and it's going to be covered in that barbecue sauce. And I've got a special surprise for you guys. I owe you guys a recipe for that blue cheese dip from our garlic parmesan chicken wings recipe from like eons ago, and today I'm going to make that dip, and trust me guys, I'm so glad it's finally happened. I remembered the recipe and I finally get to share it with you guys. Anyway, enough jibber jabber, let's go and make that barbecue chicken and that blue cheese dip. Now for this recipe, I'm using skinless chicken legs, the drumstick and the thigh, and I'm going to separate them both. And then I'm going to put big gashes on the chicken. And the idea is that the marination penetrates the chicken and these gashes will allow that marinade to sink right in. Once we're done prepping our chicken, it's time to do the first marination, which is just going to be some salt, some pepper, some chili powder or cayenne pepper, and about a tablespoon of freshly squeezed lemon juice, and give that all a good mix. Now I'm using an Indian method of marinating the chicken twice, which is what we do when we make tandoori chicken and other such dishes. So let's see how it turns out. Anyway, once it's done, we're going to let it marinate for about 15 minutes. Now it's time for the second marination, and all we need is that barbecue sauce, about a quarter cup of our keto barbecue sauce, and give it all a good mix. Now you want to marinate this for as long as possible because the longer you marinate it, the more the flavors will penetrate the chicken flesh. Once the chicken has finished marinating, we're going to put it on a wire rack in our baking tray and put it in the oven at about 200 degrees Celsius for about 15 to 20 minutes. Now while our chicken is cooking in the oven, I'm just going to make that blue cheese dip, and I'm going to take 3 tablespoons of full fat yogurt, 1 tablespoon of sour cream, and about a tablespoon of blue cheese. You can use less or more depending on how funky you want this to be. The green part of a spring onion, if you have chives, use that instead, it's better. Anyway, give that all a nice mix, a good mix in fact, not a nice mix, a good mix. And check it for seasoning. I'm going to add a wee bit of salt and a wee bit of pepper and give it all another good mix. And then just put it in the fridge till your chicken is ready. Now after about 15 minutes, I'm going to take that chicken out and I'm going to wrap each piece in some Parma ham. Now the reason I didn't do this at the start is because I didn't want to sort of overcook the Parma ham because it's very, very thin and it doesn't have much fat. Of course, if you don't have Parma ham, you can use bacon. And well, bacon you would have to do right at the start because it's generally sliced thicker and has a lot more fat on it. Anyway, once that's done, put it back in the oven and in about another 5 minutes or so, your chicken is ready. And our barbecue chicken with that blue cheese dip is ready. And oh yeah, that looks so good. All right, folks, it's time to taste the chicken and I'm going for the thigh because that's what I like. Oh, and get some of that blue cheese dip. I need to eat one more bite. Oh my God. That is some next level stuff. Wow. This chicken is cooked perfectly. The barbecue sauce and the pepper and the chili powder give the chicken itself this delicious tang and heat because the barbecue sauce is obviously reduced, the flavors have gone into the chicken, and that along with that cool blue cheese dip, it is a match made in heaven. And this Parma ham on top, oh my God, it's all of it is a beautiful combination, a great bunch of flavors. And I'm going to see you on the next episode of Headbanger's Kitchen because I got to dig into this now and finish it. Anyway, enough jibber jabber. Keep cooking and I'll see you guys soon. Cheers. Horns up, folks. We've got Headbanger's Kitchen t-shirts and Headbanger's Kitchen mugs now available. We've even got a store in the USA making and selling these, and I've put the links in the video description box below. If you like the channel, click here and subscribe. Or click here and support us on Patreon. Or click here and watch another video. And I play in a heavy metal band. You can listen to one of my songs right here. Cheers.